folks, drama, been drama, Arab drama. Last Friday, we had what in my view is the strangest National Governing Council meeting of any political party in the history of the Republic of Kenya. I'm of course talking about the most solid political party we have in the country, Orange Democratic Movement. Now, I appreciate a lot of us are getting extremely confused, because we hear what Baba has told us, and then what we see unfolding before us seems to be the very opposite. What is going on? Let's break down everything, so that we understand completely exactly what's going down here, Now, there's one big favor you can do to yourself. If you want to really understand what's going on politically, there's one very huge favor you need to do to yourself. And that favor is to leave your emotions out of this analysis. Emotions are very good. It's good to show your wife you love her. It's good to show your kids that you really love and appreciate them. I mean, even your friends. I've said this, I believe, on this channel before. It's good to show them emotion, love. There's no point of waiting until somebody passes on. And then you start saying how good they were, how did they did this. It's too late. Tell them now, okay? Those are good places to put emotions. However, when it comes to political analysis, when it comes to understanding politics, if you come with emotions, you're done. You'll just end up very, very confused. So please, that is a very important ground rule for you to be able to take in this video and to understand completely what is going down. Very important. Okay, emotions out. I know a lot of us love NASA. It pains us to hear that, NASA is no more. What's Chris saying? But another political analyst, Herman Manyora, says NASA is still there. It will not die. It will just change. What is Chris trying to tell us? Ati NASA will die. Ati NASA is dead. Now, and let's go on the other side. Let's look at the emotions from the other side. Jubilee sympathizers are just rubbing their hands in glee. NASA kwisha. Yo mzuri sana. Some are even saying, Chris, I agree with you for the first time. Today I agree with you. NASA kaput, NASA finished. I agree 100%. You're right. Emotions will not help. Right, let's get down to it. Why was the ODM National Governing Council meeting the strangest in the history of Kenyan politics? It's because there was so much tension in the air. And most of all, it's because it was the most hilarious National Governing Council meeting ever. Now, I know you find it strange that I use the word hilarious, but let me just explain what I mean by hilarious. Deputy Party Leader Ali Hassan Joho, kicks off and is just talking about ODM, ODM, ODM. He's trying to drum ODM into all the members of the National Governing Council. And obviously that is not enough. He feels what is inside he cannot keep inside anymore. So he makes a very thinly veiled attack against the principals. And he says that, they are cowards. They are people who, betray us. You expect them to do this. They don't do this. And he dresses it in such a language that if you're not listening keenly, you'll not really get what he's saying. But that is definitely a barb, aimed towards the principals. And then Kalonzo Musyoka, by the way, Raila Odinga invited both Kalonzo Musyoka and Musalia Mudavadi to this National Governing Council meeting. I believe the whole idea was to give the impression that, yes, ODM are strengthening the party, but the NASA principals are still together. That was the whole idea. Okay. Anyway, we'll come back to that later. Anyway, so Kalonzo Musyoka does not hold his peace. Yeah, he starts talking about friendly fire. Yeah, and he says friendly fire is very damaging. And then he talks about watermelons. Yeah, and he even tells us that the person who gave him the, you know, the originator of that nickname, which has really stuck to him, yeah, is none other than Baba himself. And he emphasizes that he's not a coward. Okay? So who's fooling who? Eh? Musalia Mudavadi gets up. I've never seen him so uncomfortable ever in his long political career. Never, ever. He's very, very uncomfortable. By the way, another way of analyzing this National Governing Council meeting is to look at the body language. Yeah? Very, very uncomfortable, Musalia Mudavadi. He doesn't fire any barbs, yeah, because that's not his style politically, has never been. Yeah. So what he does instead, he addresses Raila Odinga as His Excellency, the President. And the reaction he receives is very predictable. Yeah, the delegates are very happy with that and they cheer him. The long and short of Mudavadi's speech is that he said nothing. Actually, he had nothing to say. Yeah. However, as a politician, you can never stand up as a politician and tell people, I'm so and so, today I have nothing to say. You can't, because you'll be rushed to hospital. You're a politician and you have nothing to You're a politician and you have nothing to say, rush that gate hospital. There's definitely something very wrong with him. Yeah? Yeah. And that is why long-suffering citizens all over the world are often treated to a lot of boredom. Yeah, because politicians have to speak, they stand up and they basically say nothing. Yeah? A lot of words come out of their mouth, but they're saying absolutely zero. And Musalia said absolutely zero. And then he sat down. Very, very strange National Governing Council meeting. Extremely strange. Indeed, a bizarre. A bizarre National Delegates Conference. My apologies. It wasn't a Delegates Conference. National Governing Council. Yeah, this is normally representatives from all over the country. Yeah. Delegates will have more people because each wing, each branch in the country will come with delegates. Yeah, that's the difference. Now, I have to say something about Kalonzo Musyoka. Yeah, it is very sad that you can be in politics for so long, yeah, for so many years, and yet you've still not grasped the basics of politics. Okay? In politics, you don't lecture people. Yeah? You lecture students, yeah? You lecture your cabinet, you lecture maybe your political party, yeah, maybe you're the boss of that political party, you can lecture, yeah. But when you go outside there, yeah, to other people, yeah, like in this case, Kalonzo Musyoka is the wiper boss, and he was here at an ODM function, and is trying to lecture ODM people. How? Indeed, even your own party, you have to be very careful. Yeah? You don't lecture in politics. Politics is a game of convincing, swaying. Yeah? Politics is a game of changing the ground rules to your advantage. Okay? It's not about lecturing. Yeah? You need to get your class, students. Now, some of you might say, oh, Chris, you're being too harsh on Kalonzo. Yeah? So let me give you a very clear example. Now, before the January 30th, the very memorable, historic January 30th swearing-in of President Raila Odinga, yeah, there were a lot of insults flying in the direction of Raila. Oh, Raila, let us down. Oh, Raila, you're a coward. Oh, Raila, I think you've grown old. Yeah? You remember that? Yes, there are a lot of insults flying in his direction. Now, unless you correct me, I do not remember any time Raila Odinga sat down his ODM people or even anybody or even talked to any crowd and told them that, folks, I deserve some respect. Yeah? This thing of abusing me, you know, you should not abuse me. I'm still going to be sworn in. Hold your horses. Take it easy. Don't insult. This insults, you know, friendly fire is not good. Because, yes, it's friendly fire, but we have a common enemy. But when you do friendly fire, you also harm yourself. You also harm me. Did Raila make such a speech? No way. Instead, what Raila did, he held his peace. He held his horses. He waited. Yeah, and when he had an opportunity on 30th January, he was sworn in. End of story. Most people have even forgotten there was a time people were hurling abuses at Raila. They have forgotten that. Okay? But of course, Kalonzo Musyoka's style is different. Yeah, he friendly fire sio mzuri, you know. People call me a watermelon, blah, 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 blah. Yeah? That's not politics, my friend. It is not. That is a headmaster lecturing students. Yeah, they did wrong. He's trying to lecture them. He's trying to discipline them. Yeah, that's not politics. Definitely not. And maybe it is also the old Kanu tactics. You know, Kanu was mama na baba. Yeah, so politicians could lecture people anytime they felt like it. Yeah, you people are not drawing the line. You people are not Kanu damu. Lectures, lectures, lectures. Yeah, but that's not politics. And then at this bizarre meeting, His Excellency President Raila Odinga, who is also the party leader of ODM, yeah, stands up and he talks. He tells us NASA is still whole. NASA is still together. There are no cracks at all in NASA. And any, you know, this propaganda by reporters, and even threatens to mention one particular media house. Yeah. Or did he want to mention Kumekucha? You know, I held my heart for a moment there. Yeah. But anyway, he says, no, I don't want to shame them. But this is just pure propaganda. And he tells us that this is just sibling rivalry. Yeah, if you have siblings, brother, sister, they're always fighting. Yeah, but they're still brother and sister, and they're still together. He even talks about a marital situation, a wife and a husband. Yeah, they could be fighting, they don't always agree, but they're still together. Okay? Now, those who take in this channel on a regular basis are aware of the fact that I have a lot of respect for His Excellency President Raila Odinga. I have a lot of respect for that man. Indeed, I don't think there's any other politician in East and Central Africa alive that I respect like Raila. Yeah? I mean, a man who has been elected president 3 times. And, you know, the thing stolen from him 3 times. Yeah? Etc., etc. Fought for the country. I have great respect for him. However, I have to say something that will hurt most of you. Yeah? The party leader in this case, that was the wrong play. Yeah? Why do I say that? Because hours later, the Wiper party releases a statement. And they say that Kalonzo is not going to be sworn in. There's no need. Yeah? Because being sworn in is nonsense. It has no significance. People should focus on 2022. Hey, hold on a minute. That sounds familiar. Isn't that what exactly Musalia Mudavadi said? Are these people reading from the same script? Eh? Hii ni kama kitu iliandikwa mahali. They sat down and they plotted and they organized. And then they're all saying the same thing. They're all singing the same song. Focus on 2022. Now in the next episode of this series, I will talk a bit more about that Wiper statement. Yeah. But for now, after His Excellency Raila Odinga's speech, you look at what is happening. They're not the same thing. I mean, they're not agreeing with what you were saying. Yeah? Clearly, NASA does not exist anymore. Yeah? People are pulling in very different directions. Yeah? People are not reading from the same script. People have abandoned the cause that is very dear to the vast majority of the Kenyan people. Yeah? And what cause am I talking about? Electoral justice. Yeah, we cannot go on until 2022, yeah, without dealing with electoral justice, because exactly the same thing that happened will be repeated. Yeah, so this is a problem we have to deal with now, yesterday, And most Kenyans realize that. Okay? But now, WIPA is telling us, focus on 2022. Musalia Mudavadi is telling us, focus on 2022. Yeah? So how does NASA exist? Tell me. How can you convince me that NASA is still exists in the form it existed before? Okay? Because what I'll agree is that, fine, Mudavadi has nowhere to go. That's the truth, as politically speaking, yeah? And Kalonzo Musyoka, the same. They have absolutely nowhere to go, yeah? So what the right thing to do is to hang on to Baba, to hang on, you know, a loose, can I just call it a loose kind of coalition, yeah? Whereby they are waiting for things to happen. And then they jump into the bandwagon and say that, hey, we have a deal, so we should also be included. The truth is, most Kenyans will not accept such an arrangement. Yeah. So, bottom line, NASA kwisha. But as I told you the other time, yeah, this is actually good news. Yeah. Because these same old politicians were just going to take us to same old, yeah. Even if they handed over power today, yeah, it would just be same old. So a cleanup, yeah, a cleanup before we have a new Kenya is very important. I mean, we can't just have a new Kenya with the same old. So I hope you're enjoying the baby shower the way I am, yeah. I just hope and I trust that you're not going to any funerals, yeah. Yes, because there's no need, yeah. Focus on the baby shower, the new Kenya. Okay, which is already unfolding at a very, very rapid rate. Yeah, just look at what's happening in the country. And you'll know what I was telling you was absolutely true. Okay? Now, in the next episode, we're going to go a bit deeper into this. Yeah, there's some very interesting things that I need to reveal. See you there in a bit. This is Chris Kumekucha.